Have you hit that subscribe button, that notification bell? You're gonna be missing out on videos and free prizes and raffles we have coming up. This video includes timestamps, so check out the description below if you want to bounce ahead and just grab the info that you want. Hey friends, Shane from howtowrench.com, and I'm gonna try to do something new with the channel, do something a little more often, and that is to have you just simply turn wrenches with me. I'm gonna try to be able to get more content out there. I think it kills me is the editing time, so I thought, you know what, I'll just be okay with some ums and oops and those. I'll try to make the corrections as I go and anything. So that I could just get more content out there faster, especially when it comes to tools and products that support the channel. What we have here is I did an entire video setup on how to test a cooling system and diagnose it in the whole nine yards on a bike that came in RC51 that actually had a problem. You may have seen in a past video where I showed this cool tool that I made to test the radiator and pressure test it. But anyway, Mityvac gave us an extra one of these to give away to you fans. So what I want to do is I want to get that content, like I said, out there faster. One of the ways that you can really help support the channel that helps this, helps motivate me to keep going are the membership. So we got the join button down here where you get exclusive content, exclusive videos of the 700 videos on the channel. We've moved a good 100 of them over to the member only, especially a lot of the playlist stuff is a kind of a way to say thank you as well. And then we're going to come up with some new benefits too, to do like some Facebook community groups and stuff as a way to do like more Q&A type questions or whatnot. It's just really hard to be on every platform at once, right? So anyway, with this, what we're going to do in this video, and I'm going to say if you want to wrench with me, I'm going to go ahead. This DRZ 400SM is new to me. I just did some content on adjusting the valves, cleaning the carb. I did compression leak down. It's new to me, so I'm checking everything out. And a lot of work was done by another technician that, unfortunately, I had to redo the work. So the one thing that I think is extremely overlooked on people buying and servicing a motorcycle is the cooling system. It's just something that can kind of be out of sight, out of mind until it's a problem. When I especially buy a bike or it's new to me, I want to verify its integrity so that I don't have to be concerned about it. The cooling system, hence it's obvious, right? It cools the motorcycle. But what a lot of people don't know is how it actually operates. If you notice, I'm just jumping into wrenching. So hopefully you've hit that subscribe and join button and let's start wrenching. I meant to say that. What a lot of people don't know about the cooling system is that it's under pressure. And for every PSI that it's under pressure, it raises the boiling point of whatever fluid in here. I believe it's 3 degrees. I got a cheat sheet on that. But so when you pressurize that to 15, 16, you know, PSI or whatnot, you can obviously see that the fluid that's in there, its boiling point's going to be raised. So this particular bike and the R6 here, they're really important because they're going to go on the track and we know that we're going to use them at extremely high temperatures. Plus I'm in Arizona. So we need this cooling system to be working at its ultimum on top of putting in a premium product for like track days so we don't slick the track, but we just need the system to work as it's designed. So what we have here, Mityvac has come up with a tool that's more of a do-it-yourself version. It's got a I don't know if this is plastic or PVC, what this is made out of, body instead of the big commercial one that, you know, you've seen us use in a lot of our other videos. Matter of fact, I got it handy. Here is my commercial Mac one, and you can see it's made out of metal or whatnot. This whole kit, as awesome as it is, you'll end up getting in that, you know, $200 to $300 range. So for a professional, absolutely, you drop it, bang it, whatever. Gonna need it. But this thing is stupid cool. To be honest with you, I've already got one open that I've been using here in the shop for a couple months now, but what blows my mind is how it just fit every radiator cap that I've tried to test as far as a power sports vehicle, ATVs, UTVs, motorcycles. But it comes with both the cap tester and the system tester. Rock and roll. Pulled out of the box. It's like somewhere between 40 and 50 bucks on Amazon. I have the links below to this. This thing is killer. But what I'm going to do right now, we're just going to jump in and we're going to go ahead and test this new to me motorcycle and see how it turns out. If the bike is fine, I'm going to go ahead and break it and show you how the tool would act when there's a problem as well. Let's get to the next step and open up the tool and get the wrench on. Okay, get our free one out of the way. You're going to have to stay tuned and be a member if you want a chance at winning the free one. So I actually kept the box because it was a nice way to just store it. Thought that was kind of cool. Comes with all the instructions you need, an owner's manual. I'm going to show you how to do it so you don't have to worry about it. But maybe I should get a little bit closer for you. We have the pressure tester itself, and it's got a great, beautiful gauge on there. So you're going to match this up to your OEM specification, which a lot of times it actually says right on the cap. Okay. So what I need to do for this is just jump on Google and convert that 1.1 to what PSI that is. And I believe it was 16, something like that. You can Google it. The other popular caps out there for Japanese vehicles are 0.9, which gets you more like in that 13 to 14 range. Once again, Google it to be exact. We're going to check it out. It's not super crucial at this point. This is the threshold, though. If we have a 1.1 cap and it, you know, it's only holding 13, then that means the cap's bad. It doesn't hold enough pressure in the system. Okay. But if you see that, you're typically going to see a leak in the system as well. I'll explain that when I go to do it here in a second. So what this kit has that you don't have to disassemble every time, I just did it for storage purposes, is it's going to come with a hose. What you want to do is you want to slide your supplied nut on there first. We're going to go up around the nipple here. Oh, I'm so excited to test this DRZ because I'm going to throw the tank and everything back on. I got it running and rocking and rolling, and I'm going to go test drive it. Even with some shitty tires, I'm just going to ride around the block. Okay, what I'm going to do and what I like to do quite a bit, I should probably think about how storing this different. I don't like that pinch I got from storing it, but I'm going to go ahead and test my tool. I think that's incredibly important. People get into trouble. If this tool's leaking, right? Like you didn't get a good fitting here, something's wrong with the tool, last guy dropped it, whatever the case, you're going to get false results. It's going to tell you there's something wrong with the motorcycle, then there isn't. So as you've seen a lot of my videos, test your tools, right? Okay, so I'm going to put my finger over the end of it and I'm going to go ahead and just pump this up and verify that the tool has the ability to hold pressure. Boom. That tells me I'm good there. Tells me I can go ahead and test on the vehicle. We'll start with the cap tester. This thing's stupid cool. You want to make sure it's clean. Okay. Let me go ahead and set the tool up first. This is really the difference between the professional one and this one too, is the professional one, you're not really taking this apart and putting it together. If you're using this a lot, if you're a do-it-yourselfer that's using on multiple vehicles all the time, or your shop that's just choosing to spend less money on the do-it-yourself one, you're gonna have to keep cutting this off and replacing the hose over time because it's not gonna be able to come apart on and off and on and off without stretching that nipple area. Okay, so check this out. What I'm going to do is test the tool again. Just put my finger over that hole, and I'm going to make sure that it can hold. And what do we have happening? It's leaking. So that would tell me, that would give me a false indication that that my part is bad when it isn't. So I got to figure out what I got going on here. Maybe I can get this tight enough. Okay. You could see how important that is to test your tool. Okay, let's do it one more time here. Okay, now I'm ready to test a cap. Okay, here is where I think people get into trouble. Let me explain this cap a little bit. I told you, man, this video is gonna be jam-packed, right? So here's your radiator cap. You see the spring? So what happens is we put this in the radiator, we push down, turn it, and we seal this rubber seal against the radiator, and then that's what determining on the pop-off pressure of this, right, that determines what PSI the system can hold. Let's just say we're going to use 16 PSI, for example, or the 1.1 for you metrics, okay? So with that ability, we want that ability to hold that pressure in the system, and then once again, I said that'll raise the boiling point of the coolant, or the coolant, excuse me. So what you'll notice here, there's another little piece on here, and you notice this? This is pretty cool. Most people don't know what that little thing does.
is that if the radiator gets low on coolant, whether it's a leak or whether it gets boiled out for some reason, you've overheated the engine, what happens is this little tiny spring in here is another little spring. This is what the system goes, hey, I'm low on fluid, pulls that down. That's what draws fluid across. Let me show you on the radiator. See that hose right there? Well, that goes from our reservoir, okay? So that is that little tiny cap or that little tiny seal right there will go down. Fluid will go through the center of the cap, and then that's how coolant comes out of your little reservoirs. Isn't that cool? So if you ever wondered, God, how's that fluid, no matter where this is mounted, how does it get into the vehicle? That's exactly what happens. That low tension spring on the cap opens up, lets this passage go through the cap and then fill up the radiator. Now, here's another big reason I'm testing this. I said I'd do this on a bike that's always new to me, but as I bought this bike and it was just serviced by a dealer, they're bragging about how they were MMI student, did all this stuff or whatnot. I had to redo the carb, the fuel valves bad. It's been a mess, right? No value gained. I'm going to tell you that right now. No shame either. People don't know what they don't know, but is what it is. Whole nother video for that. But the radiator was really good and full, and honestly, just looks to possibly even be fresh. Hard to know without actually testing it. I'm going to flush it, of course, and put the, I'm going to use engine ice for the track is what I'm going to use. But this reservoir is empty from just being serviced. So my question is, it's a 2009. The guy told me he hadn't rode it for a couple years. He was out of Utah. Maybe he just, it leaked out. Maybe there's a hole in this. Who knows, right? Like, I have to find out as the new owner or the technician, if you will. We'll find out. I'm going to show you to test that cap. This is what I use that a lot of people, I think, don't, and you miss out on an opportunity. So let's get back to the tool here. So what we see here on this used cap is I got a pretty good buildup on here. Okay, so I'm going to clean that off. Okay. Now, hopefully, if this is pitted in here, I'm going to tell you right now, you're going to need a new cap. So I could see a pretty good ring in here. I don't see pitting. I want to clean that a little better, though. Okay. All right. Good and clean. Feeling pretty good about that. Okay. Here's where I think people get into trouble testing caps is they don't wet it. Okay. With that rubber seal, if you put that across there dry, what can happen is the seal wants to roll up and can kind of cause it to leak too. I'm just speaking from experience here. The system itself works wet, so why not get it lubed up as you install this? Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. Now my cap is on here. I'm just going to go ahead and pump it up. And it's immediately leaking. There we go. Oop. Okay, so I've got about 9 PSI in there right now. It's not leaking. Oops, I bumped it with my hand. Damn it, that's what that happened. I bumped the release, okay? It's, I don't know if it's a left-handed thing or what. So let's go ahead here. So I've got 16 PSI in here right now. And looky, no bubbles. So I got a couple different choices of what I could do here. I could go ahead and simply just, let this sit, walk away from it, go work on other things, go do what I'm going to do if I really wanted, let's say there was a concern, like there was a slow leak, okay? I'm going to tell you with these caps, they're typically, and the system itself, not always on the systems, but the caps are usually leaking just instantly. I wonder if I have a bad one laying around. I think I do. Let me show you a bad one. All right. Found one. Let's see. We're still holding good. Happy about that. So my DRZ one.
is good. I'm probably gonna have to do a little bit of editing, I guess. I'll make you guys sit through all me walking around the shop. Okay, so here is one that was replaced. And there's two things that are happening. Number one, watch the bucket. And this is why I use the bucket. You see all them bubbles? Okay. How cool is that? The advantage of the bucket. Does that make sense? Where the bucket gives you that visual to see what's going on. So that's it. There's a good, you know, a good and a bad cap. Got good examples there. So let's switch to the motorcycle itself and knock it out. Okay, all I'm doing here is I'm switching to a different fitting included in the kit. Okay, just putting that one out. Let me just show you quick. So here is our actual radiator one. I'm gonna do the same thing where I get it cleaned up, get it wet, so that rubber seal has the best chance. I'll tell you this too, if I don't wanna waste a bunch of time, you wanna clean down in the cap anyway. If the old cap was bad or in there for a really long time, it'll leave some of the cap on this seal. So you put a new cap in, you're gonna leak right away again anyway. So you wanna make sure that this is really good and clean. This literally looks like new right now, so I'm gonna be good. All right, same thing as before. Gonna mount this up. And let's do a little quiz. Let's do a little quiz. What I say I'm gonna do to the tool here. Make sure tool works. I guess I can hold PSI. Okay, we're good, right? Okay, so now all I gotta do is simply put this on just like a cap. I'm telling you, man, the fitment of this thing from Mityvac is killer. I've had some cheap ones that you end up having to grind and do a bunch of work and whatnot. So let's, excited to see. It's looking good. Oh man, I'm gonna be test riding this today. Woohoo! Let me Google what the actual Now what this is doing is if any air that's in there from the cap being off, it's pushing through all the hoses, it's pushing through the cylinder head, it's pushing up against the head gasket, it's going everywhere that coolant would be and putting the whole system under pressure as if it were running. This is a great test to do, by the way, when the vehicle's hot. You may not have a leak when it's cold, but then you get the vehicle to operational temp and rock and roll. So I'm gonna go ahead and crank this thing up. Cool as that. Let's get you zoomed in here. All right. Man, this is awesome. All right, well, I promised you. Hold on a second here. I promised you. I bumped it. Okay, just gonna set that there for now. I promised you I'd show you like a bad system, okay? And this is where it's freaking killer if you're trying to find leaks or whatnot. If you haven't seen my other videos of using baby powder or athlete's foot powder, let's say I had a leak somewhere and I just didn't know where. And I was trying to go, well, is it here? Is it here? Is it the radiator itself? Which was the case for that RC51, unfortunately. What I could do is get this really good and dry, spray the powder on there, and then I'd be able to find that leak really easy. But let's just try and create a leak right here so that you could see what that would look like. I'll get close for you. See how me being able to pressurize it will find the leak. If I take the pressure off, and you can see it's actually starting to leak real slow. Let's go ahead and take the pressure off. Look at, nothing's coming out. Can you imagine how much harder that leak would be to find? But if I go ahead and pump it up, look at, because it has that leak, it gets harder to build it up, right? And now look at,
I got it. I'll go ahead and I'm going to dump the trigger here again and show you. Look at it. Just makes it very difficult to find that leak. And then, you know, in the case here, once I know, oh, hey, found a loose hose, or found dirty, you know, a bad connection or whatever that would look like. Let me fix it. Okay, I think that I fixed my leak, right? Let's find out. There we go. Dry as can be. Hey friends, there you go. Quick and dirty, that's how you do it. This would be the best, like, I think it was $42 or $47 or something you could spend, especially as a do-it-yourselfer. And kind of a little recap, once again, this is something extremely overlooked, okay? Because it's, like I said, it's normally until there's a smell or a leak, people aren't messing with it. I don't know how many times I, you know, had a customer bring me a motorcycle for an oil change. They'd be like, yeah, I just bought this bike. I'm like, well, you think I should check it over? I did this thing called a 40-point inspection. And it's frequent that the radiator was either low to a point I was concerned enough there could be a problem, like that it was using antifreeze or something. So check it out. If you want to see like really more of the whole story or thing, you're gonna have to come back. I recorded a lot of content. I didn't feel the other content was as important as this one because I had so much of it. But for me, buying this motorcycle, I mean, it's really easy to look at tires and brakes and chains and sprockets and all that, but I was really wanting to know about the integrity of that engine. So I always start with the compression test. Very first thing, no carb job in the world will ever fix low compression. Then I know that I'm gonna do a valve adjustment. So I get in there and I do a leak down test because the motor's already in the perfect position to do the valve adjustment. Knock that out. I'm documenting all this. So I'll know that my bike had this compression, this leakage, these valve clearances. I had to go ahead and redo the carb on this, unfortunately. I have a video called The Most Overlooked Place in a Carburetor. Textbook, same thing. That was causing the engine to flood. All kinds of grief for the guy that sold this, and then I just had to redo the work. But new spark plug, check the condition of the old one. It's flooded, so it didn't really couldn't give me any good data. Had to put a new air filter in it, clean the intake track, adjusting and lubricating cables. This bike's gonna be severely modified by the time we get done. It's gonna be pretty cool. But of all the content, I thought this would be the best thing that you'd want to see that could directly help you. Go to Amazon, grab that link, get this in your garage, in your toolbox, and do the wrenching yourself. So once again, thanks for being on here. Subscribe, like, share, all that good stuff. As always, make it a great day. Stay tuned to see how we do on the track with this. And as always, keep wrenching.
Let me get in here. Lost my sandal, damn it. Oops. Didn't want to do that. Thank you.